So I fell in Bruce Lee to Leslie Mann. Well, I'm gonna sit up in the road real long. Come town, that's that cottage and the church plan. I ain't good to the more time.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? I would like to introduce this band. We got to meet them. We were down there last spring. These people are fantastic. They took care of us. They brought us all over. What a great bunch of guys and a lady. And I hope that you really enjoy them. I introduce them to you. Lada Kuelet.
ça et t'y plein plus pour être le corps dans ma poulaille. Et si j'arrête de faire tout ça, je fais des gros mots dans ma boule à serre. Moi j'écoute le coup de la grande journée. Quand ça prend des heures pour s'en manger, à côté de nous, je les prends sans prendre. La bienvenue, c'est ça, ça prend. Comment ça va, soi? Oh, il y a du monde qui parle français ici.
Oui, mais les femmes, oui. Derrière, la prétendent là-bas, les hommes ont besoin de venir ici pour danser.
Mais oui.
Ça fait pas bien derrière, ils sont venus en avant.
Mais beaucoup merci. Combien de vous autres connaissez comment danser? Hein? Il y a des danseurs ici, non? Et par honte, non? All right. We play better when we have dancers, just to let y'all know. So we had a deal. We said if there's no dancers by the end of the second song, we're just gonna pack up and leave. Well, thank y'all for coming out tonight. Merci pour avoir venu à soir. Nous entendons la récolte qui vient de la cœur de l'Acadie, dans la Louisiane. We come from Cajun country, in the heart of Cajun country, Lafayette, Louisiana, and the little surrounding towns around there. We're so happy to be here once again in Maine. We're going to play some music for y'all, and we'll tell a few stories. We're going to do an old tune that was actually an old Ray Price song, and a guy was a TV anchor on our local news channel, CBS News Channel, years and years ago, Mr. Jim Olivier. He put some Cajun words to it, or he translated and he put a melody to it, and Belton Richard recorded it, and it's a real beautiful song. It's a Rick Price song, some called Open Up the Door, Let Me Talk to Your Heart. Thank you. Si t'affroles pour entrer, peut-être je peux te réchauffer. Et c'est toi la seule qui peut faire m'ennuyer.
Symbolic for, we take old traditional Cajun music, seeds that were planted by the pioneers of Cajun music many, many years ago. And those seeds were planted, they were watered, and a harvest grew, and we feel that it's our job to continue, and we're the harvest of that crop. And we provide old traditional Cajun music like it was performed way back in the 40s and the 50s. And so on the flip side of that, as farmers ourselves, it's our chance, it's our duty to plant seeds for that next generation of Cajun musicians. So we're taking it on the road, and we're getting these young people to continue with Cajun music and speaking French and our unique culture. So that's how we get the band, and without people like you guys that support us, we wouldn't have the opportunity to do that. So we're gonna do an old tune, and I don't know how they recorded these tunes. A lot of times they just sang about what they saw, but this is something called a Eunice two-step about a little town in South Louisiana called Eunice.
Oh,
much. You need to step out. Oh, yeah. Mr. Warren, would you come up to the bandstand just a second? We're going to keep on with the music, but the bass may be cutting out just a little bit if you want to take a look at it while we may be able to do something. But we're just going to keep right on going. Yeah, well, we woke up this morning and it was cool. We had a little frost going on and we were really enjoying that because back home, we talked to family and friends today and it was about 98 degrees with 100% humidity. And we said, man, it's really a nice day over there today. It's usually hotter than that. So, yeah, it's been real nice, and but I sweat, so if you see me sweating, it's just because it's my fat crying because the music's so pretty. We're going to do a little Raymond Tozin tune for y'all. All right, actually, it's Robert Bertrand that wrote this one. This song called You For Me, Me For You. La prochaine chanson à faire, c'est quelque chose qui s'appelle J'ai tes au bar hier soir. I went to the dance last night and I'm coming back tonight. So we're going to send that out to y'all since y'all at the dance tonight. The good old fashioned Cajun fado do.
The good love win, I'm going back again next week. punto A.
That's always a fun one to do. Recorded by Mr. Ari Lejean a long time ago. Well, a lot of the songs we play, as we said earlier, they come from way back in the day, and it's unfortunate, but most of us have not had the chance to meet some of these great musicians prior to them passing away. But every once in a while, one of these old timers lived long enough to where we recognize their greatness and we're able to spend time with them before they pass on. And that's true with the next song we're going to play. The family that recorded was a bunch of brothers initially, last name of Touche. And it was the Touche brothers, and then they had a sister that joined them a little bit later on, which is the Touche family band. And they have a beautiful waltz. There's something called I Walk Alone. And we made friends with the steel guitar player, Mr. Arcones Touche, Tikun Touche. We had the fortunate honor of recording some things in the living room in his home, some music and some conversations in French, which is now in the archives at the University of Louisiana at Lafayette. So we're going to do this tune right now. We want to send that out to our friend, Mr. Arcones, who is somewhere in heaven right now.
Passer
Thank you very much. Y'all having a good time? Is that happening while I'm on top? Who's up to see? Boy, it's a good crowd tonight. We're having fun. She's 77 today. Where you at? Wave your hand. 77 years old. Happy birthday. Oh, yeah. Well, we're glad you chose to spend it with us. We're going to do a little Aldis Roger tune for y'all. We're going to take you on a trip down to Lafayette, Louisiana. A little something called Alonzo Lafayette. Thank you. Boy, it feels like we're back in Louisiana now, except for the cool weather. We got people on the dance floor, people tapping their feet. Most of us can't dance, so y'all already one step ahead of us. Y'all be embarrassed. Just come and have a good time. And we don't judge because there's a reason why we play music, and that's because we're not dancers. We're gonna do an old tune that was recorded about 1984, if I'm not mistaken, by Mr. Paul Day, Robert Elkins, and Cajun Gold from a little town where we're from. Well, two of us at least is from Church Point, Louisiana. And they have some good words to this. Pay attention to the lyrics on there. It talks about, you know, a man falling in love and he's married and she's married, and it goes good for a little while, but that doesn't always work out. So, something called The Light in Your Window.
Thank you.
So we're going to do a little song we have recorded on our latest CD. We do have, we brought a limited amount of CDs for sale. If y'all are interested, we sell them for $15 for the CD. And we can see, where's Mr. Ray and Miss Mary? Oh, in the corner right here. See these fine people right here. We got to say special thanks to our friends that, without them, our stay wouldn't be as pleasurable as it is, and we would definitely be kind of out on a limb. But these guys have really, really made us feel at home, and from the first time we ever stepped foot in their home, we were treated like family, and they fed us, and they got us fat, and we go home and we get fatter, and then we come back here and we get fatter. But they've really been wonderful. So for all the people who host us here and who put us up and make us feel like home, give them a big round of applause. We love you guys. You guys are the best. And first thing, Mr. Warren over here, when I saw him this morning, and I told him, I said, look, if you don't start nothing, there's gonna be nothing. And he gave me something back, and I said, man, we should have threw him in the swamp back in the spring when we had a chance, but we missed it. No, we love you guys, and it's always fun. We're gonna do a little song by Mr. Raymond Tozan. We should have put this one before The Light in Your Window, because I don't know what he was thinking, because it's kind of hot to do that. But a little something called Fais l'amour dans le poulailler.
Si frotte
Yes, indeed. was very popular. We have one guy here. He was very popular. He was one of the old timers, and just another one we had an opportunity to spend some time with. And he was most popular for one of his songs. And I gotta tell you a short story. We like to. It's okay if I share a little history with you guys. We'll play music and we'll have a good time. I know that's why y'all here. But we love to share our stories and our culture. But they were gonna play a song, a waltz. They were going to Floyd Swallow's record shop in Ville Platte, and they were going to cut him a record. So they all got in a car and they drove, which was from Erath, maybe about an hour and 45 minutes, 2 hour drive back in the day. And they had a waltz, which is the waltz that we're fixing to play now. And it was a beautiful waltz, and they cut that side of the record, the A side, we call it, of the record. And so Floyd Swallow said, which are going to put on the B side? And they said, man, we don't have nothing to put on the B-side. I said, well, you can't have a record without a B-side. We can't put the same song. So one of the band members told D.L. Menard, he said, what's that song you were singing on the way over here? So D.L. kind of got a little embarrassed, and he said, oh, no. He said, we can't sing that. I was just playing around with that. So Floyd Swallow said, you got to play something, so let me hear it. So they played it for him, and he said, well, I don't know, it's okay, but we'll put it on the B-side. So we always say it's on the B-side of the waltz we're going to play. And that song was La Porte en Arrière, which is one of the most popular Cajun songs. And over 60 years later, it is now listed as number 84 on Billboard's top 100 country and western tunes of all times. So I'm just glad they put it on the B-side and didn't have another tune, because it may have not got recorded. And we'll probably play that a little bit later tonight. But we're going to do the A-side of the record, something called On Bas du Champ Vert.
Because it is
see. Thank y'all for dancing. J'en tape le fer en bel diable, ensuite sur Paris. Oh yeah. How many Merle Haggard fans we got in here? Anybody know who that is? All right. We're gonna do something that we haven't done before, and when I usually say that, the band's like, oh Lord, what is he gonna do now? We're gonna do a little game, a little trivia for y'all. And Mr. Ray and Mr. Warren, y'all are disqualified. All right? We're gonna play an old Merle Haggard tune that we enjoyed so much that we changed it into a French song. And so we're gonna play it. And whoever's the first person that can come up to the stage and tell us what's the name of that Merle Haggard song, we'll send you home with a free CD. How about that? All right. Y'all pay attention now. CD, man. Come on. There you go, Mr. Sam. Y'all figured out what he was? Walking from Muskoka. Good job, Mr. Sam. Play that CD till it don't play no more, my friend. Whew, that was fun. Well, you know, we hear stories from our friends up here how the Acadians, even after the deportation, and that was kind of all settled down, and there was big logging business and fishing business, so some of the Acadian people started making their way down and settled in because of the paper mills and the logging industry, and just to have a job and work. Well, down in Louisiana, we had the big oil field boom, and we had a lot of Cajuns that were in our area that moved to around the Orange, Texas, Port Arthur, Beaumont area, even up to Houston. And they were French-speaking Cajuns who knew the music and who brought their own style of music to that area because of the oil field and the work. And this is one song that was written by Mr. Rodney Lejeune, some called Avance the Musicien, Musician's Waltz. Cajun music where it kind of went down a little low spot, and for the good old front porch music. Mitch and the band were talking about that earlier today. That front porch music, that dancing style kind of music. The band Paul Dego, Robert Elkins, and Cajun Grove brought that back into the scene in the 80s, and it's been trucking ever since. So they did a real good job. Something called The Little Shark Dressed. I teed it off cool. just our Cajun music was fiddle music, pretty much. And of course that was brought from Acadie, and you know, the styles and the influence had changed a little bit. We kind of bounced off the coast, and there's you know, some Appalachian influence in there, and you know, Scottish, Irish, those kind of things. And they used to have a barn that was probably about this size, and of course back in the day they did not have amplification. So when they would dance in a circle, when they would get all the way to the back, the fiddle is not a very loud instrument. And so when they would get in the back and they would dance, they would lose their steps, they would lose their footing. When they'd make their circle coming up front, they would catch it again. And so some Cajun had the bright idea, they were gonna take some hay tines, the hay rake, and they were gonna make that into a triangle. They call that the tifad, the little arm. And that tifad, all its purpose was to provide a beat, so when they would get in the back of the dance floor, they couldn't hear the fiddle, but they could hear the beat of the triangle to keep their step until they would make it back up front. And so from there we had Cajun music, French music, and accordion came a little bit later. We had La La music, which evolved into Creole and Zydeco music. And more recently in the 60s and 70s, they had something called Swamp Pop. And there's a lot of Swamp Pop musicians out there, and Mr. Johnny Allen's one of my personal favorite. But he did one that was a little Swamp Poppy and a little bit Cajun. And we're gonna do that one for y'all right now. It's something called The Ring That Shines, La Barre Qui Brille.
Por l'homme e por lui papa papa prie de dans mes yeux tu connais ta prémontère à mon cœur. Plus tard ce soir tu seras dans ses bras et moi je serai ici dans les espoirs. Non, je veux pas ça. Thank you.
yeah, that's some good belly rubbing music, yeah. Play that back home, you gotta make sure the lights are turned on real, real low. Don't nobody gets in trouble. Oh yeah, we said a little bit earlier, we played the A side of that DM&R tune. We're gonna flip it over and play the B side of the record right now. Once again, one of the most popular tunes in Cajun music, a little something called La Portinaria. Thank you very much. Oh yeah, what are you? Y'all having a good time up here? Yeah.
Always.
I don't know. I don't know about y'all, but I'm sounding good. I think it's y'all making me sound good. Y'all having a good time out there? Shoot, we might not go home tonight. We will be playing tomorrow at the Sunday on Sweden Street. Right here in Caribou, and y'all come back out and see us. We're gonna be jamming it up again on the street. We're supposed to have a lot of people. It's gonna be nice and cool. I think they're having the bike main that's coming through, the pedal bikes, and they're gonna be tired, and so y'all gonna be able to outdance them for sure. So y'all come out and see us. We're gonna do something right now. It's one of the most popular waltzes. If not, I'm not mistaken, it's one of the first waltzes that were recorded way back in the day when they had to get on the train and take a ride all the way to New Orleans, record their record, and then come back all the way to around the Lafayette area. Since then, it's been gained popularity and is known now as the Cajun National Anthem. There's something called a Belle Vase de Jolie Blonde. transplanted now to Maine. He lives out here, been out here for about a month, month and a half now, but he's still on probationary period. All the way from Scott, Louisiana, on fiddle and vocal. How about it for Mr. Mitchell Reed, Grammy Award winner, fiddle player. This guy's the best, y'all. Don't get no better than that. And good friend of the band's, I might add. And on my left, all the way from big old Church Point, Louisiana, on guitar and vocals, how about it for my dad, Mr. L.J. Bellard? So, our bass player was supposed to come with us and serious, but he couldn't make the trip with us and we were kind of in a bind. So we said, man, is there anybody in Maine? We were joking about it, who knows Cajun music? And Mitch said, yeah, I know somebody. I said, all right, well, let's get him. And so it's the first time she plays with the band, but it hopefully won't be the last. All the way from Bath, Maine. How about it for Mr. Elmer Joseph, y'all? Isn't she doing a lovely job? And she makes the band look really, really pretty. Yeah, we got that sound back now. And all the way from big old Lafayette, on drums and percussion, y'all give it up for Mr. Rocky Chris LaFleur, y'all.
Thank you.
time of music for y'all.
Sarpoles. Hello, is my mic on? Y'all have steaks up here? Not too many? No? Y'all know what a steak is? Hey, y'all ever seen a steak? We got a lot of steaks in Louisiana. A lot of poisonous steaks too. But we got one called the Blue Runner. And the story goes, the man who wrote this tune called Blue Runner, he was watching his grandmother pick the eggs in the hen house one morning. He was a little boy, he had his fiddle, he was looking out of the window and he saw this snake that we have called the Blue Runner. What they do, they hide in the hen house. And when you go to pick the eggs, they jump out of the straw and they chase you. And she was picking her eggs like she did every morning. Well, this morning there just happened to be a Blue Runner in there, you know. And he jumped out, started chasing her around, and she kept all the eggs in her apron. And all the eggs started flying everywhere. And Bebe, the guy who wrote this tune, he was watching her through the window. He was laughing, he thought it was funny. And when he saw her getting chased by the Blue Runner, he wrote this tune called Blue Runner. So if you ever get chased by a snake, probably won't happen up here. But if you come down to Louisiana, in fact, two days before I left to move to Maine, I had a big old water moccasin trying to get inside my Coleman stove. He wanted to come to Maine. He wanted to see what was going on up here. So, thank God, y'all lucky I didn't bring him. Is that poisonous? Here we go, Blue Runner. after Grandma ran like that, we might play a little later. I don't know if this one's good or not. But they got another song called that, Holiday. That's when Grandma, she got away from the sink to take a vacation.
Yeah, that's old time film music, yeah. I asked Mitch earlier today, what was the difference between a fiddle and a violin? He said a fiddle got beer spilled on it. That's about it. So we noticed that there was some line dancing going on. And of course we play all over the country, you guys know that. We're here in Maine, we went up to New Brunswick, played in Nova Scotia. We do California and Texas and all those areas as well. And in Texas and in California as well, there's a big line dancing population there. They love it. So there's a couple of tunes that they found, and you guys are doing a real good job as well. But this one kind of fits. So y'all get y'all line dance on. Let's something called, I got the world in a jug and the stopper's in my hand.
Thank you.
line dancers, y'all don't go nowhere because we got another one for y'all. This one's by special request, actually, of Nathan Abshire too. And I gotta explain it a little bit. You know, it's never good when you gotta explain your music. But,
four numbers. The red tickets. Hold on, we got a light on.
There you go.
There. Okay, last, now I can't see them. Last four numbers. Two. My, it's quiet all of a sudden. It's funny what money does. Five. Seven. Zero. Two, five, seven, zero. I think we have a winner.
How much is it?
$175. His name is Stan. I can't pronounce the last name. Franzak. $175. Thank you.
Doesn't that basket match his eyes? Well, congratulations to the winner. Oh, yeah. You want to do a couple Creole tunes? I'm going to do a couple Creole tunes for y'all. Creole music was the original Zydeco music, and, you know, we hear a lot of legends and a lot of stories, and we don't know how much of those are true or not, but we had something called Lala music, which was the black Creoles of Louisiana would play that music, and it was very similar to our Cajun music. And in the 50s, we had a guy from Lawtale, Louisiana, named Mr. Clifton Chenier. You guys ever heard of Clifton? He took that Lala music and he turned it into something that we know as Zydeco today, and it was a lot of influence of reggae, blues, Caribbean music, and he just kind of did his own thing and broke all the rules. And as the story, there was no such thing as Zydeco, and as the story goes, he was playing a song somewhere in New York, and there was some record critics that were there, and his ending song, his closing song, was an old Aldous Roger tune called Les Zydecos Sont Passalés, The String Beans Are Not Salted. That meant that the times were tough. Cajun would say, Les Zydecos Sont Passalés, if they weren't salted, times are bad. And so he was playing that, and it's, of course, we know as Les Zydecos Sont Passalés, but when we say it, it sounds like Les Zydecos Sont Passalés. And so afterwards, those critics came to him and said, what is the name of the, what is the music, the type of music y'all are playing? And he said, well, I don't know, there's really no name for it, it's just our style of music. And he said, what is that last song that you played that you ended the show with? And he said, oh, that's Les Zydecos Sont Passalés. And one of the critics said, that's what you call that music. You call it Zydeco music. And that's how the name Zydeco music, that's how the music got its name. So we're going to go a little bit further back than Zydeco. We're going to do a couple of Creole tunes for y'all. Some called The Turtle's Tale.
vez mais c'est pour manger du pain perdu. Pour manger du bon gombo et pour danser mais tu la fais.
Y'all get ready. We're gonna do a little Belton Richard tune. Actually, it was Hank Williams Jr. that wrote this way back in the day when he still was kind of more traditional country, sounded a whole lot like his dad, but it kind of went fast and then slow in the middle, then it went fast again, and Belton said, oh no, that's too confusing. So he just made it into a waltz, the whole thing, but it's something called A Baby Again. Said that there was this gentleman, he was a young guy, and he had gotten a job as a vacuum cleaner salesman. And you know, Belton, he would have all these beautiful songs, and I guess he kind of looked like him, so he knocked on the door, and this older lady answered the door, and she said, oh, Belton Risha. And he said, oh, no ma'am, I'm not Belton. He said, but I'm here to sell some vacuum cleaner. So he did his little thing. So He went to the next one, and he knocked on the door, and he had this old lady that answered the door, and she said, oh, Belton Risha. And he said, oh, no, ma'am. He said, I'm not Belton Richard, I'm a vacuum cleaner salesman. And I'm here to sell vacuum cleaners. So he did his little thing. She went to the next door and he knocked on the door. And when the lady opened the door, it was a young girl, very, very beautiful. She said, "Oh, Beltan Richard." He said, "Hey, hey, Lucille." That's the story I heard, and I'm gonna go ahead and stick with that. Yes, indeed. We're gonna do a little old-fashioned two-step for y'all, a little T-shirt Brothers tune. It was a little something like this. Oh yeah, we're gonna do a little tune for y'all right now. It's they're still playing, but there's some legends in Cajun music, and actually the accordion player is a female, which is not something that you see quite often. We have a few of them that are down there, but she was really the one that was instrumental in getting the other younger females to play the accordion. And she's known as the queen of the Cajun accordion, La Reine de la Cajun accordion, La Accordion Cajun. Miss Cheryl Cormier and her husband, Mr. Russell Cormier Sr. And I think they wrote this song about Russell, but it's a little something called La Bouteille, something that made them really, really popular around home. Beautiful waltz. Yes, indeed. With a little tune for y'all, it's a little upbeat. And it's a fun tune, it got a couple of bricks in it. There's something called La Veuve de la Coulée. Wet your whistle, man. Get them pipes.
Gotta wet my whistle.
Get them pipes nice and loose. Merci, merci beaucoup. Next song we're gonna do is a little song again from the town we're from, a little Church Point, Louisiana. There was an old man, he was about this tall. Of course he was old when I was growing up. I'm sure he was young at some point. But he was about this tall and he was bald on the top and he had a little fuzzy hair all the way around. But that man had one of the biggest voices and he was real high. He had one of the biggest voices around and he played with his dad, kind of like what we do here with Lotta Call. And his name was Shirley Ray Bergeron. He always put the Ray because Shirley typically is a female name. And so you wouldn't call him Shirley Bergeron because if you called him Shirley, they would think you're talking about a lady. So we all knew him as Mr. Shirley Ray. Now something called La Voz de Cherokee.
Thank you.
Thank you. That one wasn't even on the list. We just decided to go with it, man. That sounded good. Ooh. It's like y'all having a good time, man. That's good, good little tune. We're gonna do a little waltz, another one that Belton Richard recorded. Again, Belton was, he was the man. There's something called Easy to Love.
Thank you.
Merci. We're gonna do some call like special out of like a scene special. Thank you. come see us tomorrow. We'll be at Sweet and Street on the stage.
Y'all be safe driving back home.